Why can two people get the same cancer diagnosis and one stays positive while the other freaks out? The answer has to do with their hearts. We all experience heat in different kinds of challenging circumstances. One person endures the heat and even bears good fruit, while another wilts under the same sun and finds himself surrounded by thorns. The prophet Jeremiah described two kinds of people in chapter 17 of his book. He wrote, "Cursed is the one who trusts in man. He will be like a bush in the wastelands and the parched places of the desert, but blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord. He will be like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. It does not fear when the heat comes. Its leaves are always green, and it never fails to bear fruit." It's all about our hearts. Are we trusting in God or something other than God? Are we loving God with all that we are, or have we let our hearts drift from Him to love, trust, and obey other gods, idols of our own making? There are blessings promised for those who trust completely in God, of stability from strong roots, of life from a flowing stream of water, and of fruitfulness even in a hot and dry season. But there are curses foretold for those who trust in themselves or other people or anything but God. Curses like a lack of stability and security, lack of strength and life, of isolation, frustration, and fear. Jeremiah 17 gives us a picture of two kinds of people under the same sun. One tree grows stronger and bears fruit, and the other grows weaker and produces thorns. What is the heat you are experiencing? What has happened to you? Those are your circumstances that are beyond your control and are not your responsibility. But how are you responding to the heat? How have you responded well, demonstrating your faith in the Lord and bearing fruit for His glory, even in the midst of hardship? What is the good fruit that has come from those good choices? And how have you responded poorly? What thorns in your life do you need to take responsibility for? What consequences are you experiencing that are because of your weakness, foolishness, or sin? This should help you assess your situation, distinguishing the heat of your circumstances from the fruit and thorns produced by your choices. But you have to dig deeper to get to the root of the matter. You need to look under the surface to explore what you have been trusting, loving, and serving. How has your heart turned away from the Lord and looked to other things for strength, hope, and happiness? What did you want? How are your desires stirring within you, leading you to turn away from what you knew was right and to pursue something you knew in your heart was wrong? What did you want, and underneath, what did you believe? Whatever you trusted in, whatever you loved and served and obeyed, that became your functional God. You turned away from the one true God and trusted in something or someone else. The Bible calls that idolatry. One person who learns she has cancer finds her faith in God shaken. She becomes anxious and irritable, angry at God and withdrawing from friends and family into a shell of depression. She wanted a healthy life that she could control. She wanted to look a certain way and feel a certain way. Under that, she believed that her value and happiness depended on those things. In other words, she did not believe that God was enough for her, even if she got sick and even if she died. She did not trust that His plans for her were good, and so she turned to other gods to save her. Gods of medicine or support groups or alcohol or other things. The first step toward change is to admit that you have been worshiping an idol and turn from that false god to the true God. Then there is hope and power for you to change. Follow the Holy Spirit's conviction and come humbly to the cross of Jesus Christ. This is the path of repentance and faith. It is the downward path that leads to Jesus, and He will meet you there at the foot of the cross, assuring you that He forgives you and He will help you change and grow to become more like Him. By following this path, you can start to reverse your thorn-producing patterns and begin to bear the fruit that grows from loving, trusting, and obeying God. The only way to change a thorn tree into a fruit tree is to come to Calvary's tree, where Jesus died to pay for your sin and idolatry. It is here at the cross that God promises to bless the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in Him. They will be like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. Our hearts are deceitful, it says in Jeremiah 17:9, and beyond any cure of our own making. But God searches our hearts and minds to help us see our sin and idolatry, calling us to turn from that false and fruitless worship to fulfillment, power, and life that can only be found in Him. Listen to the Holy Spirit, admit your sin, and come to the cross. Jeremiah cries out, "Heal me, O Lord, and I will be healed. Save me, and I will be saved." Jesus alone offers water you can drink and never thirst again. Jesus alone can cleanse your heart and fill you with His Holy Spirit so that you can stand strong through seasons of hardship and bear fruit for His glory, even under a very hot sun. Come to Him and ask Him to change your heart. Then you can be like that other person who got the cancer diagnosis. He was scared like anyone would be, but he knew that God was in control. Deep down, he believed that God's plans for him were good, and that even if he died, he would be with the Lord, the one he loves above all things. And so God gave him the fruit of peace and joy, even in the uncertainty of his illness. The heat was beating down on him just like the other person, but by the grace of God, he drew on the power of the Holy Spirit by digging his roots into the gracious and wonderful promises of God. What is your heat? What are your thorns and your fruit? What do you really want deep down? What are you believing to be true and most important? In other words, what is going on in your heart right now? Jesus is calling you, saying, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." Stop looking in other places for the life and peace, the happiness and fulfillment that can only be found in Christ. Come to the cross. Come to Jesus.